We will study about asynchronous data link protocols in this lecture. Please download the notes from the link provided in the description. A number of asynchronous data link protocols have been developed over the last several decades. Nowadays, these protocols are mainly employed in modems. Due to its inherent slowness, asynchronous transmission at this level is being replaced by higher speed synchronous mechanisms. This slowness is due to the additions of start and stop bits and extended spaces between the frames. Asynchronous protocols are not complex, they are simple and inexpensive to implement. There is no timing coordination between sender and receiver in asynchronous transmission. It means that a receiver need not know exactly when a data unit is sent. What it needs is just to recognize the beginning and end of the unit. This is accomplished by using extra bits to frame the data unit, and the extra bits are start and stop bits. Asynchronous protocols used primarily in modem feature start and stop bits and also variable length gaps between characters. We have five asynchronous protocols which we are going to study in detail. They are namely XModem, YModem, ZModem, BLAST and Kermit. Let us study one by one in detail. First is XModem. In 1979, Ward Christiansen designed a file transfer protocol for telephone line communication between PCs. This protocol is now known as XModem, which is a half duplex stop and wait ARQ protocol. We have studied about this stop and wait ARQ protocol in the previous lecture. The frame with its field can be seen this way. You can see this on the screen. The first field is a 1 byte start of header labeled as SOH. You can see. The second field is a 2 byte header. You can see this is a 2 byte header. The first header byte sequence number carries the frame number. The second header byte is which is used to check the validity of the sequence number. Means the second header byte is used to check the validity of the sequence number which is given by the first header byte. The fixed data field holds 128 bytes of data, and the data can be in the form of binary, ASCII, Boolean, text, etc. The last field is CRC, checks the errors in the data field. And the XModem breaks the original data into a series of packets which are sent to the receiver together with additional information that permits the receiver to determine whether the packets were properly received or not. Files are marked complete with an end of file character that is sent after the last block. This character is not in the packet but is sent as a single byte. Because file length is not passed as a part of protocol, the last packets are padded with known characters, which can be dropped. Files are transferred one packet at a time. On the receiving side, the packet checksum is calculated and compared to the one received at the end of the packet. When the receiver sends an acknowledgement message to the sender, the next set of packets is sent. If there is a problem with the checksum, the receiver sends a message requesting retransmission. Upon receiving the negative acknowledgement, the sender resends the packet and retries the transmission continuously for about 10 times before aborting the transfer. XModem sends data blocks associated with checksum and waits for the acknowledgement of a block received. It is implemented in both hardware and software. It was a very simple to implement, but it lacked the efficiency. As a result of this inefficiency, modified versions of XModem were created to address some of the issues with the protocol. Eventually, XModem was replaced by YModem and then ZModem. Let us see what is this YModem in detail. YModem is a modification of XModem that allows multiple batch file transfers. It is a half duplex protocol as it does not send and receive control signals in both the directions at the same time. This helps reduce buffer overrun problems. YModem is similar to X modem in its operation, except that it sends its file name, timestamp, and size in regular X modem blocks, that is block 0, before transmitting the file. Y modem 1K uses 1 KB block size, which was one option provided in the original Y modem standard. Y modem G is considered to be a variant of Y modem, which is designed to be used along with the modem supporting error control. The G options for the Y modem is driven by the receiver, which initiates batch transfer by transmitting a G. When the sender recognizes the G, it bypasses the wait for an acknowledgement signal, ACK, stands for acknowledgement, to every transmitted block, sending succeeding blocks at the maximum speed. The sender expects a G to initiate transmission of a file and ACK on the end of the signal transmission at each file end. Unlike other similar protocols, Y modem doesn't provide any recovery or software error correction, but expects the modem to provide equivalent services. This streaming protocol sends and receives packets as a continuous stream until it is instructed to halt. Blocks are sent in succession without waiting for an acknowledgement after a block transfer. If a block cannot be transmitted successfully, the entire operation is just cancelled. Now let us see what is this Z modem. Z modem is a newer protocol combining the features of both X modem and Y modem. This design is an engineering compromise between conflicting requirements. It permits programs to initiate file transfers. It also allows senders to submit commands to receiving programs while file names are entered only once. Z modem supports menu selection where wildcard names are used with batch transfers. Only very few keystrokes are required to initiate the transfers. Z modem will step down to Y modems if the other end does not support the Z modem. This is an important point. Whenever the other end doesn't support, the Z modem will step down to Y modem. That is, it acts as Y modem. In addition to the improved performance and recovery following a communications failure, it supported expanded 32-bit cyclic redundancy checks and control character quoting, as well as an auto start by senders. It was also widely used in bulletin board systems. Z modem also supported the sliding window for better performance. Sliding window protocol permits the sending machine to move on to the next packets without waiting for an acknowledgement. We have studied about the sliding window protocols already in the previous lecture. The receiver then sends acknowledgement or no acknowledgement signals, that is ACK or NAK signals, together with the packet number. The sender then processes the messages as required, thereby reducing latency to zero and only incurring the cost of small overhead data. Now let us see what is this BLAST. BLAST stands for Blocked Asynchronous Transmission, and this BLAST is more powerful than X modem. It is a full duplex communication with sliding window flow control. It allows the transfer of data and also binary files. Kermit. Kermit is designed at Columbia University and is currently the most widely used asynchronous protocol. This file transfer protocol is similar in operation to X modem, with the sender waiting for an NAK before it starts the transmission. This allows the transmission of control characters as texting using two steps. The first step is the control character, which is used as text, is transformed to a printable character by adding a fixed number to its ASCII code representation. And the second, the HA character, is added to the front of the transformed character. In this way, a protocol character used as text is sent as two characters. When the receiver encounters with this symbol, that is this special character HA, it knows that this must be dropped and the next character is a control character. If the sender still wants to send this character, it will send two of them. In the next lecture, we'll study about the synchronous protocols.